right now I will show you how to record the changeover of fuel from low sulfur fuel oil to low sulfur marine gas oil or LSMGO or vice versa, LSMGO to LSFO. So as per my experience, the most official logbook that we have to record this changeover is the engine logbook or in the bridge logbook. So if we put a record here, we will also give a record to bridge logbook. So this is the most official logbook to be recorded, the changeover. And the other one, this is the company low sulfur record book. But I already experienced that some ports here in the Black Sea, they did not recognize this. As per the requirements, this booklet is not official logbook of the vessel. But since that it is the company logbook, we have also to record here the changeover. But the most official logbook is engine room logbook the vessel. So this one, sometimes some of the MARPOL inspector did not ask this record here in the low sulfur booklet, but rather they are checking here in the engine room logbook. So this is my personal experience. So now this one is oil record book. Some chief engineer record the change over here in oil record book, but it is necessary or not? It is not necessary to record the change over here in oil record book. So there is no circular of MEPC or Marine Environmental Protection Committee that we have to record the change over here in oil record book or ORB. So you don't need to record the change over here in the oil record book. So what letter we will use? I, letter I, when you are recording the change over. So it is not necessary. There is no circular that we have to record the change over here in oil record book. Engine room logbook is already enough, or the company low sulfur booklet. But for me, the most official record is the engine room logbook. So here have to record it here in the remarks right here. So how to record it in the engine room logbook? This one, for example, we change over at last 08 September 2022. So change over main engine number 1, number 2, and number 3 diesel generator and auxiliary boiler consumption from LSFO 0.49% sulfur to LSMGO 0.09% sulfur. So you have to write it here on the remarks area, including the date. So after that, you have to put the time start of changeover. So what time you start the changeover? 1600 hours. Position start of changeover, latitude and longitude. This is the format that you are going to write. After that, time completed of changeover. What time it is completed? 2200 hours. Position completion of changeover. So where did you find this number of hours? In FOBAS calculator. So you have to calculate in FOBAS calculator how many hours it takes to change over this consumption. And then the last record is time arrive in ECA. So what time did you arrive in ECA? Just for example, 2300 hours. So that is the time that you are going to record. Position arrive in ECA. What is the position of your emission control area? And then the most important also is the LSMGO tanks ROB. All the LSMGO storage tank, service tank, settling tank, storage port side, storage starboard side, you have to put all the quantity of these tanks in cubic meter. So you have to write this here in the remarks section of your engine room logbook. That is the format on how to record in the engine room logbook. And after that, you have to sign it here. So that is the format of changeover in passing emission control area. How about if you are in European Union country, you have to use low sulfur marine gas oil. So this is the format on how to record the changeover of low sulfur fuel to low sulfur marine gas oil when you are in European Union country. What are these European Union country? You can find it in Google. Just for example, you are in Black Sea. What are the European Union country in Black Sea? These are the Romania. All those European Union country, you have to change over the low sulfur fuel to low sulfur marine gas oil. So this is the format when you record it in the engine room logbook. Be careful, in Black Sea, you have to record it in engine room logbook. So I already experienced one of the surveyor in the Black Sea that he did not acknowledge this marine sulfur record book of our company. He only acknowledged my record keeping here in engine room logbook. So you have to record it in engine room logbook. So here, 08 September 2022, change over number 1, number 2, number 3 diesel generator and auxiliary boiler consumption from LSFO 0.49% sulfur to LSMGO 0.09% sulfur. So this is the format. So when we are in the European Union country, we only change over the diesel generator and boiler in port only, because the regulation says that in port only when you arrive in port. So time start of change over. So what time did you start to change over? Just for example, 1500 hours position start of change over. Yeah, this one. And then time arrive in ECA area. So what is this time arrive in ECA area? So this is the time of finish with engine. So what time is the finish with engine? For example, 1600 hours, that is your finish with engine. So that is the time that you arrive in ECA area or the European Union ports. So this is the position of your port. You have to record it. And the last one is the LSMGO tanks ROB. All LSMGO storage, service, and sitting tanks, you have to record the same with this format, this one. So this format, this is for emission control area when you are passing, just for example, in North Sea, when you are entering in the emission control area in North Sea or in the 200 mile, nautical miles emission control area of United States. This one, this format is for European Union country, this format. So you don't need to record the time of time completed of change over here in the format of European Union country, because as per regulation that the change over is in the port when the vessel arrive in port. But here the regulation is when you enter the emission control area. So all of this you have to record it in the logbook, official logbook of the vessel, engine room logbook. So this one, this is the sulfur record book of our company. So also I put a record here. So date time entry, date time of fuel change over, position. Yeah, so you have to record it here. Just for example, name of emission control area, Greece. So that time, date in time, yeah, that one. Date of time fuel change over operation started, this one, and then the position. And here, volume of remaining tanks of the DO tank. So I put the record it here. So this is the logbook of our company for Lusol for changeover. But as I already told you, this is not official logbook. Some of the Marple surveyor did not recognize this one, especially if they want to find you a deficiency and asking for money. So this is also our folder and changeover. So I am doing also this one when we are passing the ECA control area. So just for example, changeover of LSMGO to LSFO. So right here is changeover of low sulfur fuel to marine gas oil. So this is the onboard fuel. I write that one LSMGO. Preparation of changeover. So full bus changeover calculator. So we have a full bus changeover calculator. So this changeover calculator calculate how many hours it takes to change over the low sulfur fuel to marine gas oil when you arrive in the ECA control area. So this is one example of full bus changeover calculator. So it is a software that installed in the computer or your laptop. So this is this will serve as your guide in computing the number of hours that you have to change over before you arrive in emission control area, because as per regulation that when you arrive in emission control area, the consumption of your engine is already in low sulfur marine gas oil. It must be below 0.1%. So this one, rate of fuel consumption, example, this is for main engine. The consumption of main engine per hour is 0.8 tons per hour. So the next one is the service system fuel oil quantity. Computation of our fuel oil system going to main engine, including the mixing tank, it is 1.5 tons. And this one is, the third one is LSFO sulfur content. So what is the sulfur content of our fuel? 0.43%. LSMGO sulfur content, this is the sulfur content of our fuel when we enter the emission control area or ECA, 0.001%. Required sulfur content at engine inlet, 0.1%. So that is the requirement, so you have to put it there. And then it will automatic compute the time of changeover. Change over time to achieve required fuel oil sulfur value at engine inlet, 2.7 hour. So you have to change over the engine 2.7 hour before entering the emission control area. So if you enter the emission control area at around 7 o'clock in the morning, so you have to change over the engine at around 0400 in the morning, so that you have 3 hours time of changeover. You have to change over the engine before it enters the emission control area at around 2.7 hour. So that is the full bus changeover calculator. So here we come back here. This is for main engine, 2.7 hours. For generator, is 3.6 hours to complete. Auxiliary boiler, 3.6 hours for complete changeover. So this is the third one is the movement. So I put the record here, the movement. So you can use this record keeping in emission control area or in the 200 miles of United States of America or in the ECA control area of China. So you have to ask for your agent what are the regulation before you entering in China, United States or in Europe or in other emission control area. So this one, main engine and auxiliary engine. So this is the record. So that is a stop of transfer pump. So my movement of changeover. So all these hours and time, and then the position, as well as the auxiliary low boiler, and then the flow meter reading, and the most important also is the DO tank quantity. So all of your DO tank quantity, you have to record it here. That's all. And then the time of completion of change over this one. The last one is the entering of ICA, what time and date and the position, and then your signature and the captain, and then the risk assessment sheet, and also the change over procedure. You must have a fuel oil change over procedure. So this is your company change over procedure. So this one, main engine and generator change over procedure. This is also one of the company change over procedure as per your SMS. So all these documents are valid if you show it in the port state control. But also, you have to record it in your engine room logbook. As I already told you, you don't need to record it in the OWL record book. No, no need to record it here. So that's all, Kabaro. I hope that you get some idea on this video. Thank you and God bless. Please subscribe and like my YouTube channel as well as my Facebook page. God bless and keep safe sailing. This is Chief Engineer Eldritch. Goodbye.